What's up, guys? Jeffrey Verity Scoville here. So, today we're going to go over a workout that I just did, and it is a low-volume protocol. So this was just three working sets. So three different exercises, one set each, that's all it was. So this is a template that you can perhaps apply to your own training. So I just picked one hinge movement, one squat movement, and one unilateral movement. So the hinge gets your hamstrings, your glutes, your spinal erectors. The squat gets your quads and a little bit of glutes and adductors. And the unilateral movement gets your glute medius and keeps you healthy and balanced. So the exercise that I chose for the hinge was the deficit deadlift. Just one set, all out, one rep away from failure. And this was enough. Honestly, after this, I was so destroyed that I don't want to do another set. Another set is not really going to be beneficial. What I used to do is I used to do back down sets. So I'd finish an all out set like this, and then I would do another two or three sets with the same weight. So if I got eight reps on this first set, I might get like four the next set, then maybe three, then maybe the bar wouldn't even move. Then I would do back down sets. I would do, you know, 140 kilos or 130 kilos for more sets and just piling on the volume. And this is not necessarily very effective. If you do it right, one set is going to be enough. One set actually stimulates 60% of the maximum muscle protein synthesis. And you can actually see this, I'll put this on the screen. You can see this triangle line is the muscle protein synthesis, MPS. And one set is just around 60%. Three sets is about 75% or so. Five sets is around 85%. And it takes 10 sets to fully stimulate muscle protein synthesis. If you do 20 sets, it's still 100%. You can't go over 100%. That's the maximum. However, you have to keep in mind that the more sets you do, the more muscle damage you are incurring, especially with a big exercise like a squat, a deadlift, or a lunge. If you do a ton of volume on these exercises, you are incurring a lot of muscle damage. And a lot of this elevated muscle protein synthesis is not muscle growth. It is simply repairing your muscles to get you back to where you were. So you're taking two steps back, or more like 10 steps back, and your muscle protein synthesis rate is elevated just to get you healthy again. Whereas if you do lower volume, a lot of that muscle protein synthesis is actually going to be used for growth. Now, how do you know if you did too much or too little? How do you know if you're actually growing and anabolic, or if you're just repairing the damage that you did to yourself with your workout? I find that the best way is your appetite. Proper hypertrophy training is going to make you absolutely ravenous. So if you do a workout and afterwards you're like, yeah, I'm not really that hungry, something was probably wrong. It might not be immediately after, but if it's like 3 or 4 hours after the workout and you haven't eaten and you're just like, I guess I could eat, something was probably wrong. You either did too little, too much, too close to failure, not close enough to failure. It could be a lot of different things, but you need to change something because you are clearly not growing. Growth takes energy. It takes a lot of energy to actually create this new tissue and slap it on to that existing muscle. And you know, looking back at my training log, I've always gotten really good results from low volume programs. The reason I keep shying towards high volume is because I keep reading research that says high volume is better. But a lot of this is not really completely honest. If they're measuring growth in a high volume program, a lot of that is glycogen, it's inflammation, it's bloat, it's just water in the muscle, and it goes away after a week. After you stop doing high volume, it's just gone. Now, I've had workouts where I deadlifted 30,000 kilos in a single session, or I squatted 17,000 kilos in a single session. And I didn't really see very much growth from this because my body was just destroyed and any kind of muscle protein synthesis was just repairing the damage that I did. And in terms of strength, my strength actually went down from these crazy workouts, like 16 sets of 10, whole bunch of sets of 20 to 30 to failure, this kind of just ridiculous training that is excessive and typically gets you nowhere. So I would try a low volume approach. A lot of the people who claim that high volume is better, they're either looking at this research that is not completely honest, you know, it is measuring inflammation, bloat, pump, it's not actually measuring muscle growth, or they're on steroids. You know, if you're using anabolic substances, wow, yeah, suddenly you can recover from more and your max recoverable volume is going to be higher. So if you're a natural, even if you find that someone on steroids is a good source, remember, they're still on steroids, and their view of volume in particular is going to be very, very different. So if someone is on steroids, often they will find they can recover a lot better, and they can train a lot more, and they benefit from a lot more training. But if you're not in their situation, that might not be acceptable and applicable and applicable to you. All right, keep in mind, I do have a few coaching positions open, not a ton. I'm not going to take on like 20 clients just because that's going to be crazy. I'll probably keep it to 10, maybe 15 at the very most. So if you're interested in working with me, drop me an email. It's in the description. All right, that is all for today. Make sure to like the video, subscribe, notifications on, etc. And I'll see you next time. Peace.